So when we talk about conditional formatting, it means the formatting which is based on a particular condition, on any condition it should be formatted like this or that. Suppose in conditional formatting, not color changing is there. You can do bold, italic, underline, you can choose font colors, borders in conditional formatting also. Basically it is a formatting based on a condition. So let's try with some predefined options. Here some predefined options are being given, and after that we will know about these things, how to create manually conditional formatting, because most of these things the people know, but they don't know about these creating new rule, creating a manual system with conditional formatting. So I tell you in detail. Suppose that I have such kind of data. Let me select first the data where I am going to apply this conditional formatting. I have selected some numbers. In conditional formatting, the first option is highlight cell rules. It will highlight on particular these rules. There are greater than. You can set your value to here so that highlight those values which are greater than 70 or whatever you choose, and you can choose your formatting color from here. What type of format do you want here? It is there, or you can create from your custom. You can choose custom format from here, and you can choose how it will show you. Suppose I can choose yellow color. The font should be bold there. Okay. So it will work like that. Before moving towards new conditional formatting or to other option, I need to clear the earlier one first, because sometimes we don't remove the previous conditional formatting, and what happens, the conditional formatting overrides with it. The old one is there and the new one goes there, so it creates a mess up of conditional formatting. That's why it doesn't work properly sometimes. So we need first to clear rules from, you can choose from clear rules from entire sheet or clear rules from selected cells. I've chosen selected cells. Now you have option less than. Highlight those values which are less than 20. So the value will be highlighted here. Likewise, you have between, the value between 20 to 30. You can choose as per your requirement. Equal to, when the value is equal to 50 or 18 or 79, a particular value you can give here, and the cell will be highlighted according to it. And after that, text that contains. So let's move to text. Here I have typed some number. I select that and I choose text that containing. So here we can give partial text also, such as the words which are containing N, the words which are containing H, the words which are containing P. So we can do a partial content of text. A date occurring. Let's move to date. In date occurring, you have lots of options according to date, such as you can highlight the yesterday values. Once you have set this rule, so what was the date yesterday? It was 20th April 2014. So the date will be highlighted here. Suppose if we look this value tomorrow, then the today's date will be highlighted here. So I use this basically, I do some account job and I use this thing for seeing how much checks are going to expire in next day. It is like that. I create rule like that. And in date occurring, you have today option, tomorrow option, in the last 7 days, such as last week, this week, next week, last month, this month, and next month option. You can choose these as per your requirement. Now you can highlight duplicate values also. Suppose if you want to see there are lots of duplicate, I select a particular text like this, and if I choose duplicate value here, the duplicate values will be highlighted there. If I choose unique from there, the unique values will be highlighted here. And there are top and bottom rules. It works on number. Like filters and sorting, we do like this. Suppose we choose top 10 items. Top 10 doesn't mean that it can only show you the 10 items. You can increase your number as you like. Top 20 items. Top 20 means the highest 20 items. Highest 5 items I can choose. Highest 50 items I can choose. So I can increase the numbers as per my requirement. The next one is top 10%. Top 10% means the all values goes to 100%. The sum of them are 10,821. So that which values are containing 10% of data, top 10% means the values are highest and their sum containing the 10% value of sum of the total values. Top 10%, or you can choose top 20%, top 50%. You can choose from here according to your requirement. If you choose bottom 10, it will show you the bottom items. Bottom item means in ascending order from shortest to largest, it will choose the shortest one, shortest 10 items. And likewise, here is bottom 10%. Bottom 10%. And above average, the values are above average. And there is below average, the values are below average. Now let's move to data bar. It also works for numbers. It only works for numbers. In data bars, it create a chart here. Chart like image in your column. the maximum value will be shown as full bar and the lower value will shown a least bar, such as there I type 100, so it will show me full value, but when I type 1 it will show me the least value. So it is up to the value that it will behave like charts. I clear rule from here. In data bars you can choose different colors from here, such as like data bars we have color scale. What color scale we are using? A screen tip shows here green, yellow, red. If we want to know the difference, so for maximum value it will show green, for middle value it will show yellow, for least value it will show red. Suppose if you are increasing the values, the shade will be more darker towards that word, towards that color. So it is a color scale representing based on the values. You have icon sets. The icon sets are the criteria of choosing values. Suppose here are some values, here are sale, which is good, we show it as a right mark, which is so-so, we choose a sign of exclamation there, and which is bad, we choose sign of cross there. This sign. So any signal I can choose for my values. Now let's say for 90 it is showing right, for 50 it is showing a sign of exclamation, for 10 it is cross. So such as the conditions, you have different icon sets ranging from 5 icons, 3 icons to 5 icons. So you can choose the icons as per their priority. You can use this icon also, this one, the red light style, these icons, mobile tower like items, moving directions. Suppose your sale is going up, you can show 90 as an, if your sale is good, you can show this this right sign. It is good but not the best, not the topest. The for average you can use this sign, it's somewhat good, but which are really going down you can use this one. But there are different arrows. If you I have told you that you can also sort your values based on cell icons. So your cell icon will be selected here. You want to show the down arrows on top, you can choose. So this is a type of conditional formatting. The icons are very good concept to recognize the data easily in one go, just like charts. Now let's move to manage rules. This is a master dialog box for creating new rules and editing rules or setting the priority of rules of conditional formatting, such as you want to create a rule, you can select new rule. There are the all the functions here. So let me choose the numbers here, and I can choose new rule from here also. Format all cells based on their values. So I can choose two color scale such as gradient, three color scale such as that scale bar, data bars we can use, icon sets we can use. Now we have used that icon sets. I can choose my icons from here, three signs and red to black. No, this one not. In three signs I will choose I use this one. Now I can choose my value percentage on the basis of percentage or on the number. Suppose when the value is greater than or equal to 70, it should show the up sign. When the value less than 70 but greater than equal to 50, I choose number here, it should show the equal arrow, the equal sign here, like this arrow, this yellow one. And the value below, which are less than 50, it will automatically show this down red arrow. When I press OK, it will work like that. So now I want to edit the rule. I will go to manage rule, and here I can edit or I can delete the rules. From this one you can see the conditional formatting from this worksheet or any particular sheet or from current selection. So when you double click that, it goes to edit mode and you can choose the order. Suppose you want to reverse the icon order, you can use check this reverse icon order checkbox, then the all icons will be reversed. But if you don't want to show values there, you want to show only icons there, you can choose this button, show icons only. When you apply this, it will show icons only. The value in formula bar, it will show you, but here you will find icons. For making it more creative, you can use data bars here. In data bars, show bar only. So it will show bar only, not the values. You can select this rule or delete from there. When you apply, the value will be set as previous. Now let's move to other option of new rule. Format only cells that contains means cell value between this one to this one. You can choose your format option from here. you can choose a specific text and text containing some value, not containing some value, beginning with some text, ending with some text, you can choose from here. Date occurring, you have all the same option like in highlighted cell. Blanks, the value which are blanks. No blanks, the value which are not blank. Errors, the cells which are containing errors, you can highlight that. No errors, the cells which don't have any error. Top and bottom ranked value, the all the predefined functions are available here as per your choice, such as top 10% or top 10 items, top or bottom, you can choose from. Format only values that are on above average, below average. You can choose from here, above, below, equal or above, equal or below. After that you have first standard deviation, some statistical function here. Format only duplicate or unique values, you can choose from here. And the most important thing, the manual process for creating the cell, which is very very useful. Use formula to determine which cell is to be formatted. In this you will put a formula in which when your value becomes true it will format as you set the format in it. So let's use a formula in some condition. Suppose you have some device sales here. For sales for 7 days, I choose here. So here are some sales in which I take an average of 400. I want to highlight those values in which the person has made sales of rupees more than 400. The sum of the sale should be more than 400. So I want to highlight those sales here, more than 400. But we don't want to add this sum column here. So how will I create the formula? Yeah, I will use this sum, select a range. This is normal sum. The logical function which returns true or false, we will use the sale. Is the sale is greater than equal to 400, greater than equal to 400. So it will return result in either true or false in Boolean value. So these type of formula we need for dealing with conditional formatting. So once I have created a formula here, let's understand for applying a conditional formatting. If I apply a conditional formatting here, first I need to apply in single cell, then I will copy their formats from format painter. So the dragging options also converts the range reference. If I drag this value to here, so first the range is D2 to J2, but when I go to in second row, my range moves in another direction. My range keep changing, but I don't want my range to be changed. I want that this range should be maintained, but while dragging down, this should go down. So what I will do, I will freeze these values and put a dollar sign in front of D and J. What will happen when I drag them to here? It will not make any changes in my selected range. But when I drag down, then it will be keep changing their range on a particular area, particular direction. Now I have a formula with me. I will copy that formula and let's move my cursor to first S1. And in conditional formatting, in new rule, I will use this use a formula to determine which cell to format. I will paste here and set my format here. I will choose yellow and font as bold. Okay. Now I will use format painter to copy the format and select the area where I want to apply the format. Now these cells are different. I will change in date format. Now you can see the each one of the cell which has greater than or equal to value sum of 400, it will be highlighted here. By this way, we can use formula in conditional formatting. So, by this way, you can create conditional formatting. But let's suppose you have some type of list here, some type of names left or whatever it is. This is list one. And in my list two, I have some names. Now, when I want to know that are these names are in this list, I want to highlight those items which are available in list 2. How will I do that? For manually, we will track these values through VLOOKUP or some other method. Like this, and VLOOKUP returns us this thing. Now what happens, the names which are in that through VLOOKUP are showing their names. So I will create a logical function here is equal to this name or not, because I want values in true or false. So my logical operator will work here. I drag this. So somewhere it is returning me true, but in some places it is returning me an error. So I will just copy this formula, and of course I want to freeze that. If I want to work in a particular way, now I just copy this formula, select first cell, new rule, use formula, and here I put the value, and again choose the format as orange. Okay, and now with the help of format painter I will apply there. When I add some name here, it will automatically highlight. You don't need this. So it is dynamic. We can highlight ourselves, we can condition ourselves based upon a condition only. We can format ourselves. So let me just tell you about some interesting facts about formula. We have some mathematical operators which are plus, minus, multiply, divide, and what are the next is caret. It is for power. Plus, minus, multiply, divide, and power. Every time we don't need to put formulas in our calculation, we can use these operators proceeding with equal to. So first thing first, how to start a formula? We can start our formula with equal to, minus, plus, and minus. But it is recommended to start a formula with equal to, because plus minus creates some changing in our data. Suppose if we are starting our value with minus and selecting something, the value will be returned. If I use plus 1, so it plus 1 value will be positive, but it show negative. So it suggested that you should start the formula with equal mark. You can use these marks also for a starting formula. So when we start a formula, we can easily plus or minus values, multiply them, divide them, and we want to know the power 3 to power 2, so it will be 9. 4 power 2 means 16. We also have a power function for that, the number you choose and the power you choose. So you can use your mathematical formula, more mathematical operators here for mathematical calculation, such as you do have some logical operators which are equal to, greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to, and not equal to. These operators return the value in true or false. That is called Boolean values in programming terms. It is true or false. So these true false we use in conditional formatting. So how we work with them? Less than, greater than equal to, and less than equal to, and not equal to. So we suppose we have column A and column B stating some values. So if we want to check that 10 is equal to 20 or not, so we will get result in true false. It is not, but when these are same, it will show true. So we don't need to put if formula every time if we want the result in true false. Most of the people use if formula for evaluating these logical result, but the fact is you can use separately without any if function. What if function do, if you type if function, there is a logical test done by these logical operators. And when you want to you have two options here, then value if true or value if false. So in value if true I provide equal, and value if false I provide not equal. For inserting text directly to formula, we need to put text in these inverted commas. Either if I want to choose the values from specific cell, we can refer their name to it, such as H10. H10 means this column H and the 10th row. So it is stating my result like I want. So for true false we don't need that if function. We can choose from here also. We can choose greater than G10 false, but it when it was greater than, it is true. Greater than equal to means like this name, greater than and equal to. It will work if the value is 20. It will work if the value is greater than 20. And 19, it will show me false. And likewise, there are less than equal to, but we have not equal to. It is asking, is F10 is not equal to G10? It will return us true statement. Yes, it is not equal to. So we can use logical operators in conditional formatting, in formula, and data validation. Both are of same type. Apart from that, we have some operators from text here, which is and sign. What it does, when you type a name, two text in different item, different cells, and when you want to show them into one cell, you can choose this one. In between, you can press and, and you can select this one, second one. So it will show you the result in single cell, that is called concatenate. You do have a formula for that, that is called concatenate, in which you can choose the text as you want. You can choose multiple of text here, separated by commas. Now, if you want to show space here, you need to put it in inverted commas, because we are directly inserting text, and press another and. The operators work to join these values in a single cell. So it will add a space here. So that's how you deal with formulas and with conditional formatting. So, sir, we have done with conditional formatting and formula introduction.
Yeah.
Okay, so do you have any questions regarding that?
No, sir, it's fine for me. I'm comfortable.
Oh. Okay, okay. So we will, you will be on leave tomorrow. And
no, I won't be there tomorrow because the same timing I'm flying actually back to Dubai.
Okay, okay. But the day next tomorrow we will meet.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Oh.
Thank you. Good night.